Good morning, children. Welcome to class 9th IIT Mathematics. In previous class, we have discussed about the discount, profit and loss. Now, in this class, we will discuss about the partnerships. What is partnership? How the partnership will be? And in what way the partnership is going to be? Partnership amount will be calculated if the profit is there and if the loss is there. So children, in this chapter, we will discuss about the partnerships, because in first class, we have discussed about the percentages, in second class, profit and loss discount. Now in this, we'll discuss about the partnerships and to solve the problems. So in this partnership, some capital is there. Capital means the amount what we are going to invest. That is called capital. Okay. So the total amount of money required to start a business is called its capital. That means the amount that we are going to invest to start any business, then that is, that amount is called capital amount. Okay. Partnership. Partnership means two or more persons come together to start a business jointly. Such business is called partnership business. Okay. So if one person is there, that is single business. If two or more persons, they are going to come together and they are going to plan and start a business jointly by investing some amount or some capital, that business is called partnership. Okay. The next is partners. Partners means the people who jointly runs the business are called partners. That means, example, X person is there, Y person is there. Then those two people we are going to say as partners, because X is invested some money and Y is also invested some money. Then those two persons are called partners. So investment. The money invested by the partners in the business is called investment. That means the amount that we are going to put in the business by the partners. Okay. That amount or that money is called investment. Okay. Types of partnerships. So that we are having two types of partnerships. The first one is the period of investment is same and the partners divide the profit or loss in the ratio of their investments. That means, see, so here, the period of investment will be same. Example, for 1 year or 2 years or 3 years. Example, X person is investing 10,000 rupees. In the same way, Y person will also invest same amount, that is 10,000 rupees. And they will get either a profit or a loss after 1 year. Okay, if they are getting the profit, they are going to share that amount. Or if they are getting a loss, they will share that amount. Okay, X person is going to invest 20,000 and Y person will be investing 10,000. But the time period should be same. Okay. Then that is the first type of investment. And the second type of investment is compound partnership, we are going to say. That means the investment periods will be the different. Okay. So example, X person invested 10,000 rupees. Okay. And Y person also invested 10,000 rupees. But after 3 months, again, X person has invested 10,000 more. Then automatically, that means after 3 months, the amount will be 20,000 of X and 10,000 will be Y. So these investments are called compound investments, or the X person may take certain amount. Okay. So here we'll do some problems. So your first question is, Satish and Kranti started a business with capitals of rupees 12,000 and 18,000 respectively. The business made a profit of rupees 3,500. Find the share of Kranti and Satish in the profit at the end of 1 year. That means here Satish and Kranti are the two persons. They have started one business. Okay. So Satish invested 12,000 rupees and Kranti invested 18,000 rupees. So this amount is for 1 year. So after 1 year, they are getting a profit of 3,500 rupees. Okay. So we'll calculate the how much, that means that profit has to be divided equally. That means based on their investments, the profit has to be divided. So how much profit the Satish will get and Kranti will get, we'll solve. So first we'll solve the Satish. That is, investment made by Satish is equal to rupees 12,000. And investment made by Kranti is 18,000. So now we'll calculate the ratios. Ratio of their investments is equal to 12,000 is to 18,000. So after simplification, I'll get a ratio of 2:3. That means 2 parts Satish and 3 parts Kranti. And as the period of investment is same, that means this period is same for 1 year. The profit is also divided according to their ratios of investment, that is 2:3 ratio. Okay. So your total profit is 3,500 rupees. Okay, they got a profit of 3,500 rupees after 1 year. Now this 3,500 rupees has to be divided in the ratio of 2:3. If Satish is getting 2 rupees, then Pranthi has to get 3 rupees. So in that way, we need to divide. So here the total ratio is equal to 2 plus 3 is 5. The total ratio is 5. Now I want Satish share. Satish share in the profit is equal to 2 by 5 into 3,500. That is profit. That is 2 by 5. 2 is Satish ratio and 5 is total ratio. Satish ratio by total ratio into 3,500 rupees. Now that's equal to 1,400 rupees. That means Satish will get 1,400 rupees. Okay, from 3,500 rupees, if you are subtracting 14,000 rupees, 1,400 rupees, then automatically you will get the remaining amount. Or this in the same way, you can calculate the same way in this way also. Kranti share is equal to 3 by 5 into 3,500 rupees. So that's equal to 2,100. Okay, you can calculate any one share. If two persons are there, one share you calculate. If their time period is same, so simply from 3,500, if you are subtracting 1,400, then automatically the share will be 2,100. Okay, in case if the time period is different, then we'll do the next problem here. Rakesh set up a factory with a capital. Capital means invest, first starting investment of rupees 90,000. Ramesh joined him later with an investment of 50,000. That means Ramesh has joined after some time. The amount is 50,000 invested. The total profit earned at the end of year is 68,000. That means after 1 year, they are getting a profit of 68,000. Then find when Ramesh joined Rakesh as a partner, if Ramesh share in the profit is 48,000. That means see, Ramesh share is 48,000. Okay, so here first I'm going to calculate the investment of Rakesh is 90,000 and investment period is 12 months. Investment period is 12 months. Then Ramesh investment is 50,000 and investment period will be X months, because how many months he joined, we don't know. So that's why ratio of the investments of Rakesh and Ramesh will be 90,000 into 12 months is to 50,000 into X months, because so here I don't know the Ramesh period. So that's equal to 90 into 12. If I'm simplifying, I'm going to get 108 is to 5X. Okay, so your four zeros will be out. 12 nines are 188 is to 5x. Now here total profit earned at the end of the year is 48,000. Total profit is 48,000. So Satish share in the profit is 48,000. Okay, so your Pranthi's total profit earned is 68,000. Sorry, total profit earned at the end of the year is 68,000 and Satish share is 48,000. Now here Pranthi's share is equal to total profit minus Satish share, Ramesh share minus Rakesh share, that is 68,000 minus 48,000. That's equal to 20,000. Okay, ratio of their profits is equal to 48,000 is to 20,000. So that is equal to 12 is to 5. The ratios will be 12 is to 5. So here ratios of investments is equal to ratios of their profits. That means investments ratio should be equal to the ratios of profit. That means in that way they are going to divide. So that's equal to 108 is to 5x is equal to 12 is to 5. Okay, so that is 108 by 5x is equal to 12 by 5. That's equal to 5x into 12. After doing cross multiplication, 5x into 12 is equal to 108 into 5. Then x is equal to 108 by 12. That's equal to 9. Okay, investment period of Ramesh is equal to 9 months. Okay, Ramesh joined Rakesh as a partner after 12 minus 9 months. That is 3 months. After 3 months, so Ramesh has joined the business. Okay, they asked how many months after. That means after 3 months, he has joined, because 9 months he was there. So next question is, Ramesh, Gopi and Sharat started a business with initial investments of rupees 10,000, 20,000, and 20,000 respectively. After 6 months, Gopi withdrew an amount of rupees 5,000 from his investment. After 3 more months, Sharat brought 10,000 rupees. If the end If at the end of the year, the total profit earned is 36,000, then find the share of each partner. So here three partners are there, Naresh, Gopi and Sharath. They have started with an initial investments of 10,000, 20,000 and 20,000. Naresh investment is 10,000, Gopi and Sharath will be 20,000 each. But here, after 6 months, Gopi has taken out 5,000 rupees. That means for 6 months, it is 10,000. After 6 months, it is 5,000. Then after 3 months, Sharath brought 10,000 more. That means Sharath has invested 10,000 more. That means after 3 months, the Sharath's investment will be 30,000. Then the total amount of the profit earned is 36,000. Then what is the share of Naresh at the end of the year? And what is the share of Gopi at the end of the year? And what is the share of Sharath at the end of the year? So here first I'm going to calculate the Naresh. Naresh investment is 10,000 rupees. Period is 12 months. Okay. So total investment made by Naresh is equal to 12 months into 10,000. That is 1,20,000 rupees. That is the first equation I'm taking. So next is investment of Gopi, 20,000. So in that 20,000 investment is for 6 months, because after 6 months, he has taken 5,000 rupees. That is amount drawn, withdrawn is equal to 5,000 rupees. So for the remaining 6 months, the investment will be 20,000 minus 5,000 is 15,000. Okay. 15,000 amount is there. The next, for this 15,000, again, I have to calculate. That means total investment made by Gopi is equal to 6 into 20,000 plus 6 into 15,000. That is the second equation. Okay. And investment of Sharath is 20,000. Period of investment is 6 plus 3, 9 months. Because so after 9 months, he has given 10 more thousand extra. That means 10,000 he has kept. So here, investment for remaining 3 months is equal to 20,000 plus 30,000. 10,000 is equal to 30,000. The total investment made by Sharath is equal to 9 into 20,000 plus 3 into 30,000. That is the third equation. Now, from 1, 2, 3 equations, okay, ratio of their investments, that is investments of Naresh, Gopi and Sharath ratio is equal to 12 into 10,000, that is Naresh, and 6 into 20,000 plus 6 into 15,000, that is Gopi's. 9 into 20,000 plus 3 into 30,000 is Sharath's. Now, after simplification, that is 1,20,000 is to 2,10,000 is to 2,70,000. So, here all four zeros will be cancelled. That is 12 is to 21 is to 27. Now, after simplification, I will get 4 is to 7 is to 9. This is the ratio of their investments after 1 year. So, total profit earned at the end of 1 year is equal to 36,000. Total profit is 36,000. Now, this 36,000 should be divided in the ratio of 4 is to 7 is to 9. That means Naresh is going to get 4 rupees, Gopi will be getting 7 rupees, and Sharath will be getting 9 rupees. Okay. So, in that way, the total ratio is 4 plus 7 plus 9 is equal to 20. Now, Naresh share in the profit is equal to Naresh ratio, that is 4 by total ratio into total profit is 36,000. So here that after simplification, I'll get an amount of rupees 7,200. That is Naresh profit, Naresh share in the profit is 7,200. And next is Gopi share. That is 7 by 20 into total profit is 36,000. That's equal to 12,600. Gopi is getting a profit of 12,600. And last is Sharath. Sharath's share in the profit is equal to 9 by 20 into 36,000. That's equal to 16,200. So here Naresh share is 7,200. Gopi share is 12,600. And Sharath share is 16,200. Add all these three shares. Then we'll get an answer of 36,000 rupees. That means this 36,000 is going to be divided in the ratio of 4 is to 7 is to 9. The amount we are going to get is 7,200, 12,600 and 16,200. Okay, children. Thank you. In further classes, we'll discuss some more problems on this. Have a good day.